Hey, what's up, y'all? This is Troy McLawhorn from Evanescence, and you're watching Dunlop TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's your buddy Brian Kehoe from Dunlop TV, and today we are hanging out with our new friend, Troy McLawhorn.
What's up?
From Evanescence. So tell us how you got this gig.
I just got a call from Amy. I've been touring with a band called Dark New Day, and we kind of met back in those days because we toured with Seether. She called me and Will Hunt, and we came in on the 2007's tour and finished it up for them. I made an album with Seether in summer of 2010. We finished it, and we were getting ready to go on tour and stuff. And you know, Amy and I have kept in touch. You know, we got together, and she told me that she was ready to start making another album. I kind of told her my story. You know, I was ready to do something else, and she welcomed me back into the band, and we went into pre-production 2 weeks later.
Tell us a little bit about your influences, like when you're coming up, learning how to play guitar. What was the moment, or what was the inspiration that said, you know what, fuck it, I want to do this?
Me and my parents lived out in the country in this trailer park, actually, until I was 10 years old. We moved into the city, the big city of Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Giant.
Yeah, and I met this guy that became my best friend. You know, we lived right down the street from each other. I met him like the first week I was there, riding my bike in the neighborhood. And his dad was a musician, so there was amps and guitars in the house. We used to, in his bedroom, we would jam. You know, he had his drum kit set up right in the corner of his bedroom. We would jam in there, and all these kids from the neighborhood would be watching through the window. You know, it's cool. There's little girls out there. The girl you wanted to hook up with is watching you play guitar.
Yeah, buddy.
I think that's probably when I was like, okay, this is what I want to do. So, and after I graduated high school, I moved down to Atlanta. I started touring with this club band. Went on the circuit playing bars, playing 3 sets a night, 6 days a week. Touring the East Coast.
It's a hard lifestyle, man.
It's a rough lifestyle, but if you're drunk all the time.
And you're young.
It's not so bad.
Yeah, right. Now, hold on. You said drunk. Now, what's your drink?
My drink, I drink Stella Artois.
Back to the things at hand here. What are you taking out on this tour? Guitars, amps, pedals?
I'm taking out my PRSs. I've got a couple of Gibsons that I'm taking out with me because I actually had a bunch of gear stolen from me. So I had to bring out some of my Gibsons, which I love playing my Gibsons, but PRS is, they endorse me, you know, and that's usually all I play on tour. I got orange amps. They sound awesome. As far as on the floor, I've got Digitech Whammy. I've got a Jimi Hendrix Wah, Zakk Wylde Overdrive, and a Kerry King. Is it a Tim Bandy Q?
Tim Bandy Q, yeah. With the stereo out?
Yeah. And I've had a TC Electronics Chorus Flanger pedal that I've had for a long time that I've used on just about every album I've ever played on. I've got a Boss Chorus and
digital delay,
a Boss Digital Delay. I don't know if it's a DD6 or DD7 or whatever. I gotta tell you, on the album I used the Zakk Wylde Overdrive through an old Plexi Marshall.
Nice.
It's a great pedal. It's a really...
I'm not going to argue with you.
You know, I don't feel like you lose any of the low ends. And you get a little mid boost, but it's a good frequency that gives you, puts you in the sweet area, you know.
Do you tune down?
We've got, on the last tour, I had 10 guitars and 10 different tunings just for the set. I'm playing a 7-string now. Because it helps me not have to switch guitars so much. And you gotta use heavier strings. I mean, everybody, if you don't know this, you gotta do that because it gets floppy.
Segway, speaking of strings, lay it on me, man. What are you using?
I just switched to Dunlop and...
Go figure!
Yeah.
Can you imagine that?
They're great, man. You know, the reason I like Dunlop so much is I love the tightness of the bottom end on the strings and the brightness of them. The strings sound new for longer. you know, we go through all these different climates, hot, cold weather, you know, and they still sound good.
So what kind of picks do you use?
I've been using Dunlop picks for years. I like the, you know, the nylon Dunlop picks, and that's what I'm using now.
All right. Well, we're going to get to some beer drinking and having some fun.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate
so much.
It, man.
Are you kidding me, dude?
See you guys on tour?
Awesome. Oh, yeah. Get a Stella Artois.
Right.
Jameson and then a Stella.
Actually, Macallan.
Oh, man. Adios, amigos.